Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. This is part two of my tutorial showing how to create your own cool-looking vintage vehicle logo. Picking up from where we left off, reduce the fill of your logo to 0%. Making the fill zero makes the logo invisible, but will retain the visibility of all the effects that we'll be adding to it. Double-click on the thumbnail of your logo to open its layer style window. Click Gradient Overlay and change the Blend Mode to Color Dodge. If your gradient bar isn't black and white, open your gradient presets and click the black-white thumbnail. The style is linear. Make the angle 90 degrees and drag the scale slider all the way to the right. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is inner bevel and the technique is smooth. Make the depth 20%, the direction up, and the size 7 pixels. Soften is 0. Uncheck Global Light. Make the angle 135 degrees and the altitude 37 degrees. Open the Gloss Contour presets and click the double ring thumbnail. Make the highlight opacity 35% and the shadow opacity 100%. Click Contour. Open the presets and click the half round thumbnail. Change the range to 33%. Click Inner Glow. Change the blend mode to Linear Dodge and slide the opacity to 100%. Click the color box and pick a medium color that complements the color of your vehicle. I'll type in a medium blue, 3B8FED. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Make the choke 80% and the size 6 pixels. Click Stroke. Make the size 1 pixel, the position outside, and the blend mode screen. Click the color box and pick a rich color that fits within the color scheme of your logo. For mine, I'll type in 1858FC. Click Drop Shadow. Change its blend mode to normal and click the color box. Pick a very dark shade of your color. I'll type in 010103. Make the opacity 100%. Uncheck Global Light and make the angle 90 degrees. The distance is 5 pixels, the spread is 100%, and the size is 10 pixels. Then click OK. Next, we'll add a soft drop shadow. Make a copy of your logo by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Hide all the effects except drop shadow. Double-click drop shadow to see it in the layer style window. Change its blend mode to multiply and reduce its opacity to 25%. Make the distance 24 pixels, the spread 18%, and the size 18 pixels. Then click OK. Next, we'll add a reflection on the middle of the logo. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Ctrl-click or Command-click on the thumbnail of the logo to make a selection of the inside of its shape. Go to Select, Modify, and Contract. Contract it 6 pixels and click OK or press Enter or Return. Press Q to make the selection into a Quickmask. Open your Pen tool. We'll create an arc path like you did earlier. Click to the left of your logo, approximately a third of the way up from its bottom. Release your cursor, go to the right of your logo, and press and hold Shift as you left click to make a horizontal path. Release your cursor and go to the middle. Press and hold Alt or Option as you left click to add an anchor point. Then, press and hold Ctrl or Command as you drag the anchor point up approximately this much. Complete the work path surrounding the bottom of your logo. Right-click directly on the path and click Make Selection. We don't want to feather it, so type in 0 pixels. Press Ctrl or Command plus Delete to fill it with the background color, which is black, and then press Q again to make the quick mask back into a selection. Press B to open your brush tool and increase its opacity to 100%. Reduce the brush size by pressing the left bracket key on your keyboard. Keep your brush mostly below the selection and brush across your logo. Then deselect it. Reduce its opacity to 70%. The last step is to add a lens flare. To do this, first, make a composite snapshot of your image by pressing Ctrl-Shift-Alt-E on Windows or Command-Shift-Option-E on a Mac. Then, go to Filter, Render, and Lens Flare. Make the brightness 80% and the lens type 50 to 300 mm zoom. Drag the lens flare to a point on the top of your logo that's vertically aligned with the sunset. If you're using a different background, drag the lens flare to any point that looks good to you. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.